Which version of Starship holds the title of most powerful? Until now, it was the V-3. However, a new contender, the V-4, has emerged. Musk has unveiled this new version, showcasing significant developments and ambitious aspirations that push the boundaries of what we thought was achievable. So, what makes the Starship V-4 so powerful, and why is it important? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. We are currently witnessing the final launch of the V-1 booster into V-2 spacecraft. The V-3 model is expected to mark a significant leap forward for Starship, representing a shift in design and capabilities, setting the stage for future achievements. For a long time, many, myself included, believed the V-3 would be the massive 150-meter version that has been repeatedly teased. However, recent clues suggest otherwise. It appears the V-3 is not that giant model, and a more advanced design is on the horizon. Now, this design has been officially acknowledged. In Musk's technical update presentation before the 10th flight, the launch of the Starship V-4 was revealed. The slides show that the V-3 is only 124.4 meters tall, making last year's update inaccurate. The V-3 should now be considered a bridge model. The V-3 features innovative improvements such as a new capture point, an updated heat shield on the spacecraft, an updated hot staging system, redesigned grit fins for the Super Heavy, and a new engine model. While these features are certainly impressive, the truly transformative changes are only available for the V-4. The most significant modification to the V-4 is its increased height. Initially believed to be the V-3, this height has now been confirmed for the later version. Starship V-4 will be 142 meters tall. While this is not the anticipated 150 meters, it does suggest that future versions may reach that height. At 142 meters long, the Super Heavy will be 81 meters tall, exceeding the current V-1 booster by 10 meters and surpassing the planned V-3 booster by 8.7 meters. The ship itself will be 61 meters tall, which is 10.7 meters taller than the V-1 and almost 9 meters taller than the V-2 and V-3. Interestingly, the V-3 ship will not see an increase in height compared to the V-2, meaning its improvements will focus on system refinements rather than size. The increase in height results in an increase in fuel capacity. The Super Heavy's fuel load will now be 4,500 tons, which is 800 tons more than the V-1 booster and 400 tons more than the V-3 booster. The ship will carry 2,300 tons of fuel, exceeding the V-1 by 1,000 tons, the V-2 by 800 tons, and the V-3 by 700 tons. Due to an increase in fuel mass and taking the dry weight of the vehicle into account, Musk anticipates that Starship V-4 will have a total weight of 7,500 tons. The ship's newly expanded structure will create a more spacious payload bay, enhancing Starship's capabilities to transport additional cargo and passengers, as well as accommodating larger mission loads for deep space exploration. With upgraded fuel capacity, the new Raptor 3 engines are expected to deliver the significant thrust necessary for this craft's movement. Super Heavy V-4 is set to generate 10,000 tons of thrust, a goal SpaceX has aimed for over a long period. The ship itself is projected to produce 2,300 tons of thrust, an impressive figure for a spacecraft destined for orbit and beyond. A closer examination of these thrust figures reveals an intriguing aspect. Currently, the Raptor 3 generates 280 tons of thrust at sea level and 306 tons in a vacuum. Equipped with 33 engines, Super Heavy will produce 9,240 tons at liftoff, falling short of the coveted 10,000 tons mark. Similarly, the current engine setup on the ship would yield around 1,758 tons. This indicates that the Starship V-4 is likely to not only have enhanced Raptor engines, but also an increased number of them, which Musk has confirmed. In a recent update, he disclosed that Starship V-4 would be outfitted with 42 engines, including 3 extra Raptor vacuum engines, as the ship's length has been increased to fit them. The technical slides showcase the revised engine layout for V-4, confirming its expanded design. This rise in engine quantity will significantly enhance performance, bringing it closer to SpaceX's objectives. There is also the potential for further improvements with Raptor 3X or even Raptor 4, which could provide greater thrust per engine. Even with the increase to 35 engines on Super Heavy, additional power will still be necessary to consistently achieve and exceed the 10,000-ton thrust target. Similarly, the ship will require these enhancements to comfortably attain and surpass 2,600 tons of thrust.
With advancements in size, power, and design, SpaceX believes Starship V-4 will be capable of transporting over 200 tons to low Earth orbit. This capability is crucial for missions to Mars. To achieve this, SpaceX is not only enhancing size and thrust, but also streamlining the vehicle by simplifying parts, minimizing unnecessary weight, and boosting efficiency. These improvements are evident in the engine design, the hot staging system, and other structural enhancements. Musk has also provided a timeline for V4. According to his recent comments and presentation materials, this version is expected to take flight in 2027. This target date is intentional, aligned with the broader timeline related to the Moon and Mars endeavors, which are predicted to ramp up towards the decade's end.
Musk has indicated that while the V3 has the potential to reach Mars, the V4 is more likely to succeed. This is logical, as the V4 would offer better performance, increased capacity, and greater reliability for such a mission. Practically, the V3 may still play a role in some test flights, including the highly anticipated Optimus robot demonstration. However, the V4 is expected to be the primary flagship, designed to meet the requirements of full missions to the Moon and Mars. Furthermore, the V4 will serve as the foundation for variants needed by NASA for the Artemis program and lunar landings. The transition from the V3 to the V4 marks an ambitious step forward in SpaceX's Starship initiative. It highlights the importance of the V3 for testing and refinement, while the ultimate goal has always been the V4, which will pave the way for interplanetary travel. What do you think of this exciting new version? Are you excited about the Starship V4? Leave a comment with Let's Do It to share your thoughts. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible journey in space exploration. To prepare for the launch of Starship V4, SpaceX faces a significant amount of groundwork. If the goal is to fly a V4 in 2027, then a prototype must be ready by the end of 2026, leaving only 2 years to ramp up production, expand infrastructure, and upgrade test and launch facilities. The first priority is production. The new Star Factory must reach its full potential, and a massive gigafactory currently under construction will be crucial for assembling the larger and heavier V4 prototypes. Completion by mid to late 2026 will enable unprecedented stacking capabilities. Test facilities will also require upgrades. Larger test stands, improved quick disconnect systems, and expanded locations will be needed to accommodate more vehicles and ensure the V4's engines, structures, and systems are properly validated. Upgrades to the launch pad will also be necessary. At 142 meters tall, the V4 will require taller towers, sturdier section cups, reinforced orbital launch mounts, and fire trenches. New towers are already under construction to facilitate these future launches. Fueling is another critical aspect. The V4's size requires large amounts of propellant. Therefore, SpaceX is assembling an on-site air separation unit to produce fuel at Starbase. This facility is projected to be operational in mid to late 2026, perfect timing for an initial prototype. If progress continues as planned, SpaceX will launch V4 in 2027, bringing Starship closer to its ultimate goal of transporting humans and cargo to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. The next 2 years will likely be crucial in SpaceX's history. However, before progressing to the incredible V4, SpaceX must navigate an exciting and crucial phase with Starship V3.
Musk's latest technical update highlights that V1 has been set for 2023 and 2024, while V2 is targeted for 2025. V3 is expected to take center stage in late 2025 and throughout 2026, ahead of the launch of V4 in 2027. This raises questions about Starship development. SpaceX aims to launch the first V3 flight by the end of the year. Musk mentioned that V3 should be built and tested, possibly flown, by the end of this year, suggesting that production is already underway. At Starbase, Booster 18 is nearing completion in Mega Bay 1, while the initial section of Ship 39 is beginning to emerge. With only one V2 launch remaining, attention is quickly shifting to V3. Musk emphasized that V3 should complete production and testing by the end of this year, with extensive flight activity on the horizon next year. The importance of V3 lies in its numerous enhancements, with Musk calling it a substantial improvement over V2. Key improvements include hot staging, new grip fins on the Super Heavy, a redesigned heat shield, updated capture points on the spacecraft, and the introduction of powerful Raptor 3 engines. According to official slides, the V3 will also feature a larger size, increased fuel capacity on the booster, and significantly higher thrust during both stages. These improvements will increase payload capacity to over 100 tons, a substantial increase from the 35 tons on the V2. These improvements will directly increase the variety of missions Starship can undertake. Musk envisions the V3 reaching Mars, potentially acting as a prototype for the first uncrewed missions to the Red Planet, similar to its role in uncrewed and even early crewed lunar missions. Following its success, the V4 will be ready to tackle larger and more complex tasks, such as transporting people, establishing bases, and facilitating resource extraction on other planets. Additionally, Musk recently revealed that the V3 will also engage in several orbital refueling tests next year, a critical capability for long missions. While the V4 represents a significant increase in size and power, it will serve as a bridge demonstrating Starship systems in real-world scenarios. 2025 and 2026 will be crucial years as V3 showcases its various improvements and prepares for the significant advancements that V4 will bring. The prospects for Starship are increasingly promising, starting with a refined and reliable V3, followed by an impressive V4, ready for the race to the moon and Mars. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one.